Rich Bracken. Hey, Rich, good to see you.
This morning we have Rich Bracken joining us.
And Rich Bracken, our Why Not guy.
Because you offer a unique perspective.
The one thing that I wanted to do was really put a lot of inspiration and motivation and positivity out there, because we know that there's the reverse everywhere now.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to give you the most effective tool that you could possibly have in your personal and professional life, and that is emotional intelligence.
90% of high performers have a high emotional intelligence. So your intelligence, your IQ, can get you to a certain point, but your ability to relate to other people, to listen, to engage, to be socially aware, to be personally aware and manage your own emotions can actually put you on a quicker path to leadership.
All right, number three.
Huge, 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 social media. Go through your followers list. Go through your Facebook, your Instagram, your Twitter. Look who you're following, because the people that you follow, whether you actively follow all their content or not, as you're scrolling, there's a mental trigger that's going to make you feel negative, that's not going to spark joy, because you're seeing their name, you're seeing their content, you're seeing their face. Now's a good time to go through and purge that list. Nothing's too silly.
No rules.
No rules.
No mistakes.
No rules whatsoever. The only time you don't have any rules, right then in journaling. Hopefully your handwriting is better than mine. Bring out those positive emotions. And it's building that habit and building the momentum to being a more positive, balanced, emotionally intelligent person.
What is the first thing you see at the top of the box? Urgent. Last minute. Need this today. Request. And what do you want to do? You want to punch today in the face.
I need to find a reason that I want to accomplish it and that it's going to make me happy. Because, you know, I could go and sell through the roof. And if my boss comes back and says, great, okay, now your goal's gone up, and I'm basing my happiness off of their response, I'm not gonna be satisfied with what I did.
And he needed some courage, didn't he?
He needed some courage, but he also said, put him up, put him up. This is all about being courageous, because all these things are great, but if you don't have the courage to attack your problems and go for your goals and really stretch yourself, you're not ever gonna get to that point. If you're gonna get into this, come on, you gotta keep the momentum going. Put them up. Studies show that 50% of people fall into some sort of anxiety or depression in looking at other people's social media profiles. So while we're always constantly battling that struggle of trying to be the best person that we are, we're also looking at social media, we're looking at people's pictures and not thinking about the story behind those. So you may see somebody driving a great car, but they may be up to their eyeballs in debt paying for that car.
Stressed out.
Exactly.
To the
totally,
max.
Totally stressed out.
So when is it okay to be angry?
You know, candidly, it's okay to be angry anytime. Anytime okay. Something gets your emotions, you know, like Mark said, we are taught all the time to play nice, keep your emotions in check. But truly, feeling angry is one of the best things you can do, because it's okay to get angry, it's just how you deal with it.
And I know that when I get in my car, I can manage my mood with whatever music playlist I pick. But I know that I have that to set forth my day, and I have it on the way back. So if I have a rough day at work, I have a playlist for that. It's very Celine Dion heavy.
We all want to help, and we all want to be there to support those, mm-hmm. whether they're colleagues, friends, family. But the most important concept is you have to look at yourself like you have an emotional bank account.
Right.
And if you're constantly doling out emotion to support these people, eventually you're going to start running out. So if they're constantly talking negatively, or something's just, there's always this sour outlook on things, let them finish and then say, great, tell me something good that's going on. Tell me something positive. What are you happy mm-hmm. about? And it flips their mentality. And it's also kind of a passive way of saying, you're really negative,
yeah.
and I'm really tired of this. So let's talk about good stuff.
My happiness is in my control.
Yes. You do you. You find your happiness within, right. because as things shift, so if you think about everybody that's got their own mindset, we're all going about our days, and if you're trying to make me happy or you're trying to live up to my expectation of happiness, then you're never going to be happy, because that's constantly going to shift. It's finding that happiness within yourself, because only you can identify with that.
You are going to have disagreements. You're not going to see eye to eye with everybody. But if you can at least have the patience and the emotional intelligence to listen and understand somebody else's point of view and see where they're coming from, that will help you in some critical communications.
I don't have to necessarily change my perspective, and I don't have to change my thoughts and my beliefs, but if I understand yours, that actually gives me more ground to stand on. If I have a stronger foundation because I've opened up my thoughts to other people, and now I can say, hey, I've believed this before, and now I understand the other side, so I can be more convicted in what I think. It's called reverse engineering your dreams. Yeah. I did a podcast about this a while back, and it's fantastic because you envision what you want to do. I know that there were some pictures of the New York City Marathon that I ran last year, and I envisioned what it was going to look like crossing that finish line.
Right.
I knew what it was going to feel like. And so as I was training, I kept picturing that in my head. And as I crossed the finish line and that picture came up, That was exactly what I envisioned. And so I kept thinking, okay, if I want to cross the finish line, this is what I want to do. I need to get to a point where I'm stronger, a better runner. So I just backtracked to, and I got to where my starting point was.
But it's the ability to understand that sometimes it is your place to step up and resolve that conflict. It is your place to speak up. It is your place to defend somebody, personal or professional. It's okay to be that person. You may see the solution, but if you stay silent, you're complicit to the problem.
Find the core value of happiness in everything that you do, because there's always going to be a frustration. There's always going to be something that's out of balance. And so if you can find those core happiness factors within everything that's in your life, you can always go back to those.
We've all thought we were beautiful at some point in our life. And at some point, somebody told us, or we felt that we had to compete. And so we started chasing that standard of what somebody else was doing, what somebody else was saying, how somebody else was living. So getting back to the core of who you are, what you enjoy, what makes you happy, what makes your heart beat every single day, get back to those things and don't apologize for those. You are beautiful as you are every single day.
Such great advice. I bet you're a fabulous husband.
So exercise your emotional intelligence muscles and become stronger at it by just paying attention to who you are, what you feel, and acknowledge your thoughts and your feelings when certain triggers set you off.
Because I truly, truly understand the value of it, because I've lived it. I was not the best at it. Now I'm a lot better. I'm not perfect at it, but I'm a lot better. And I've seen a tremendous change in my career and my daily life. So I empower you all to do that. I empower you all to be humble, to change the course, to become happier, better people through emotional intelligence.